Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our winter cut. 2 years. That's how long it's been. Thanks to all of you for the many hoops that you go through to sign up and register and come masked. We are thankful for science and all of our medical professionals for helping us get to this place. These students are prepared and they're excited to share with you tonight. On behalf of the Bryn Mawr School, on behalf of the middle school, we just want to welcome you warmly. We're gonna have a great time. Everybody take a deep breath. Just keep it behind here. And I hope tonight that you fill your life with peace and joy and laughter and hope. And just maybe tomorrow we'll see a few little snowflakes. We shall see.
I've been staring at the edge of the water.
going to have a bit of a transition because we have some strings and ensemble players that are going to make their entrance. So we're doing everything we can to keep the flow of air running in certain directions. This crew's going out into the quad and then back into the dining center and the student center. And parents, when the concert is over, you can pick them up outside in the quad. They are ready for you. So while we set up, and I know that there will be many people all around me here, and while they are, I'm going to try to explain the emotions of what it has been like for the students, talking to them and seeing what they have encountered, waiting and hoping that we could sing again. They, of course, have normal jitters and nerves. They also, I'm going to actually move here so that this piano can disappear. When I'm coming down here, you don't need to see my face. Well, I'll sit right here. Holiday stories with Mr. Joy. 2 years is a long time to not sing. We have 29 students in that first choir, 35 in the second choir you will hear tonight, and 15 in the third. And for some of them, the last time they sang on stage, they were in fourth grade. So their voices have changed and are changing. There's a little science behind why we have three choirs, sixth grade, seventh grade, and eighth grade. It happens. Across the street, it sounds a little more like sixth grade, seventh grade, and eighth grade. But girls' voices change too, right? Their voices are changing, and we get to talk about that. We talked a little bit how Jack Frost is just about to nip at our noses again. And, you know, we can be terribly serious in these times, so I'm going to ask some questions, and I would love some audience participation. What did Jack Frost say to Frosty the Snowman? Have a nice day. I warned Jack about starting his own ski resort. It's a slippery slope, because, you know, Mr. Twining's terrible jokes. But don't we all need a little laughter this year? Isn't it good for us to laugh? It's good for us to breathe and laugh and cry and feel things. This world is different than it was a couple of years ago, right? And so for us in middle school, we like to talk about things that are positive, things that are brightening our day, ways to make our world better, ways to make Baltimore better. And we hope that we're playing our small part, all right? This one's just for those who are below age 13 and in the audience. What does December have that no other month has? What do you think? Yeah. Oh, I hope there's snow. Maybe January and February sometimes have snow, yes? Well, there are certain holidays, yes, yes. What does December have no other month has? The letter D. All right, let's try another one. This one's just for the parents. Where do snowmen put their money?
Yes!
In a snowbank, the first one of the night. Very good. Let's give a big round of applause for the snowbank. All right, this, you just have to be under age 10 for this one. What do you call it when a snowman throws a temper tantrum? Yes. Are you under 10? I heard that deep change voice. What's the difference between a Christmas alphabet and the regular alphabet? I think, on a more serious note, as we prepare for this, that we think a little bit more about things that we can take for granted. Singing is just something I've done since I could. When I was 3, my mama set me on a piano and we would sing. I sang downtown in Baltimore at the Hyatt Regency, the one that has those great big glass elevators, you know? And I was going in one with my sister. We thought it was the coolest thing we'd ever seen. And here comes Stevie Wonder. So he was in there and we like rode up and down for a while. It was really cool. I had no idea who it was, but I learned later and I'm like, wow, that's really cool. And that something happens when we can give our hearts music. It brings a little bit more joy into our world. So if you would please join me in welcoming Dr. Daniel Levitoff and the Bryn Symphony.
Thank you. third piece on the program, I'd like to welcome to the podium a very special contributor to our Bryn Symphony program. Mr. Alan Branch is a Dorothy Claiborne Fellow here in the Bryn Mawr School, and he's been working throughout the arts department, but especially here with the Bryn Symphony, assisting us. He's a wonderful musician, wonderful educator, and we are so thrilled to welcome him to the podium to conduct the Schubert theme. Church community, this one by an African-American woman, Ephraim Brown, that's Canaan Land. So it was really fun to combine these two together, and I thought just as the Sacred Harp, by the way, refers to our voice is our Sacred Harp, and for this group, our symphonic sound is our Sacred Harp. So I hope you enjoy our final piece. Thank you.
Pondering the lights up here, the lights all around campus. Isn't it wonderful to just come up and see lights? It seems like we've been celebrating lights for a little while. We have a need for more Diwali, more Hanukkah, more Christmas, more lights. Lights are a great way to put out the message that, hey, we're here. And I think that last year, without singing, which broke my heart, we put up an obscene amount of lights. I didn't even do my usual picky thing about only a certain kind of lights. We had little bulbs, big bulbs, white colored lights, all kinds of things because we wanted to make it so special for our 4-year-old daughter. And this year it's even more special because she said, do we get to do the lights again? So we decided to celebrate all of the holidays with all of the lights that we could. Oscar Hammerstein of the famed duo Rodgers and Hammerstein, who wrote The Sound of Music and many wonderful Broadway productions, said this: a bell is not a bell till you ring it. A song is not a song till you sing it. Love in your heart wasn't put there to stay. Love isn't love till you give it away. So this evening, these musical offerings are our way of saying we love you. And we love the fact that we can celebrate community together at Bryn Mawr. There is a change in your program. We're going to perform the song Sing, which we thought was an appropriate title for this year, followed by selections from Disney's Frozen 2. We have three Latin names for our choirs. One is Cantemus, that's sixth grade, that means we sing. Seventh grade, which you'll hear in just a moment, is called Exclamemus, from which we get the word exclaim, or to sing out, or to make some sort of thing declared. And the last group I inherited, I didn't make up this name, is Sumus Dei. It's a beautiful name. It means we are goddesses. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. That was absolutely phenomenal. I'm not surprised at all about who was soloist tonight. You all have beautiful voices. This is one of the best turnouts we've had for a middle school concert, and I get the sense that it's because we're all hungry to be back together and back with music again. Mr. Twining, it did my heart good. So I hope you will join me in thanking our amazing faculty, Mr. Twining, Mr. Branch, and Dr. Levitov for this evening's. We're wishing you all a happy and safe and healthy holiday season. I will have a few more thank yous, Mr. Denton in the booth, Dr. Kaduri, Ms. Stratton, all my right-hand people in bringing this together. A round of applause for our behind-the-scenes folks. Tomorrow is Winter Spirit Day, so find your green, gold, and white, and send your children an out-of-uniform spirit attire. We are going to take a few minutes to get our students from the Student Center and back into the North Building. We're going to unlock the rooms where we have their things. But we do have to clear out this area pretty quickly because the upper school concert will start in a few minutes. So thank you for waiting patiently in our quad and North Building lobby. Have a wonderful evening. Thanks for coming.